electric pecan nutcracker. Does a really good job if you want to have a lot of halves. It has a big percentage of halves in here. Some you might have to still peel off a little bit, but very good percentage of halves in the electric pecan cracker. Although you do them one at a time, you can do up to 1,500 pecans in an hour. All right, fantastic. Electric pecan nutcracker works great if you want to crack pecans. It will also work on native pecans, which a lot of nutcrackers do not. Okay, we'll show it in action in just a minute here. You put the nut end to end, so there's a more of a chance of it cracking and giving you like a half or whole pecan. We found it's best if you sit in front of the machine in a relaxed position and with the motor side on the left-hand side of you, just like this. Made in the USA. And first of all, it's always a good idea to wear safety goggles, like something like this. Safety glasses, just in case the nuts come shooting out of there, you never know. All right, we're going to turn her on. It works by putting them in one at a time as the little tube rotates around. You try to put in as it's going around, and as they're going around, put them in the hole. And now we've got cracked nuts. Let's just do a few more. As it's going around, just pop in the nut. And we got cracked pecans. Also, we've discovered that the best way to do it, to start it off, because we don't want a dry fire. We want to, each time it goes around, we want to try to be able to put a pecan on it. So when we start it, we turn this handle. We turn this little handle. And then we make sure that it's, or we do it right at the top. So it has plenty of room to spin around before it starts, because if you start another position, you can't get a nut in there right away. Also, it's a good thing just for the dry fire, because it's a really powerful shot there without a pecan in there. So when you end your session of nuts, just come over here and just turn the switch to turn it off as soon as you can once you know that you're done. So that's how you do it. So for example, we'll just do it again. Just turn it on, and as it rolls around, now you're ready to put the first nut in, and you won't need to dry fire. All right, now turn it off. As this up position is the place where the spring is most relaxed, so that is the place where your machine should be at rest. Not with the hole down here, that puts more tension on the spring because it's ready to crack. So this is the place, the start position. And the end position. This closed position is also the position that you want to leave your nutcracker when not in use, as this will extend the life of your machine to have it in this position so that the spring is loose within the machine. And also ready for the next time you crack it, so it'll sit in the right position. Here's some pecans that were cracked in the electric pecan nutcracker just now. ElectricPecanNutcracker.com